Whatever that probe is picking up, it's reading life form.
What do you mean a life form?
Oh, the head.
For centuries, humans have been fascinated by the possibility of life beyond our planet. With advances in technology and the discovery of thousands of exoplanets, the possibility of alien life has been gaining traction among many scientists and in the general public alike. From the potential habitability of other planets to the search for biosignatures in their atmospheres, scientists are using a range of tools and techniques to uncover the secrets of the universe and search for signs of life. In this video, we will explore four key questions about aliens that have been the subject of much speculation and research in the scientific community. From the likelihood of finding life beyond our planet to the ethical considerations of making contact, we will delve into the mysteries of the universe and attempt to answer some of the most intriguing questions about the possibility that we are not alone in the universe.
When we're looking for life in the universe, it seems to make perfect sense that there should be planets like our own out there, maybe even moons like our own planet around gas giants that could be habitable. It's hard to define even what life is, but we can maybe do a better job in defining the sorts of things that life does. And that provides some aspects to some avenue for looking for them. Classically, conventionally, I think we thought the way to look for life was to look for oxygen. Oxygen is a byproduct of photosynthesis on this planet. We didn't always have it. Certainly if you go back to the Archean period, there was, you have this period called the Great Oxidation Event where the Earth floods with oxygen for the first time and starts to saturate the oceans and then the atmosphere. And so that oxygen, if we detected it on another planet, whether it be Mars, Venus, or an exoplanet, whatever it is, that was long thought to be evidence for something doing photosynthesis. So that was conventionally how we thought we could look for life. And then we started to realize that it's not so simple because A, there might be other things that life does apart from photosynthesis. Certainly the vast majority of the Earth's history had no oxygen, and yet there was living things on it. So that doesn't seem like a complete test. And secondly, could there be other things that produce oxygen besides from life? So we've been trying to generalize. And certainly in recent years, there's been other suggestions, things we could look for in the solar system and beyond. Nitrous oxide, basically laughing gas, is a product of microbes. That's something that we're starting to get more interest in looking for. Methane gas in combination with other gases can be an important biosignature. Phosphine as well. And phosphine is particularly relevant to the solar system because there was a lot of interest for Venus recently.
The universe is vast and contains countless stars and planets, making it seem likely that life exists beyond our planet. In recent years, advances in technology have allowed us to discover thousands of exoplanets, some of which may be capable of supporting life. Scientists also continue to search for signs of life in our solar system and beyond, using probes, telescopes, and other instruments to gather data and search for clues.
So there's a very long list of technosignatures that people have suggested we could look for. The earliest ones were, of course, radio beacons. That was sort of Project Ozma that Frank Drake was involved in, trying to look for radio signatures, which could either be just like blurting out high power radio signals saying, hey, we're here, or could even have encoded within them galactic encyclopedias for us to unlock, which has always been the allure of the radio technique. But there could also be unintentional signatures. For example, you can have something like the satellite system that we've produced around the Earth, the artificial satellite system, Starlink type systems. You could detect the glint of light across those satellites as they orbit around the planet. You could detect a geostationary satellite belt, which would block out some light as the planet transited across the star. You could detect solar panels, potentially spectrally, on the surface of the planet. Heat island effects. New York is hotter than New York State by a couple of degrees because of the heat island effect of the city. And so you could thermally map different planets and detect these. So there's a large array of things that we do that we can go out and hypothesize we could look for. And then on the furthest end of the scale, you have things which go far beyond our capabilities, such as warp drive signatures, which have been proposed. You get these bright flashes of light, or even gravitational wave detections from LIGO could be detected. You could have Dyson spheres, the idea of covering it, basically a star is completely covered by some kind of structure which collects all the light from the star to power the civilization. And that would be pretty easily detectable to some degree because you're transferring all of the visible light thermodynamically, it has to be re-emitted, so it would come out as infrared light. So you'd have an incredibly bright infrared star, yet one that was visibly not present at all. And so that would be pretty intriguing.
While there have been many reports of UFO sightings and claims of extraterrestrial encounters, these have not been verified by credible scientific evidence. The possibility of extraterrestrial life remains an active area of scientific investigation and speculation. It is important to approach discussions of this topic with a healthy dose of skepticism and to critically evaluate any claims or evidence that is presented.
Actually, I'd say there's three big problems for me with any search for life, which includes UFOs or the way to fossils on Mars, is that aliens have three unique properties as a hypothesis. One is they have essentially unbounded explanatory capability. So there's almost no phenomena I can show you that you couldn't explain with aliens to some degree. You could say, well, the aliens just have some super high-tech way of creating that illusion. The second one would be unbounded avoidance capacity. So I might see a UFO tomorrow and then the next day and then the next day and then predict I should see it on Thursday at the end of the week. But then I don't see it, but I could always get out of that and say, well, that's just because they chose not to come here. You know, they have this, they can always avoid future observations fairly easily. If you survey an exoplanet for biosignatures and you don't see oxygen, you don't see methane, that doesn't mean there's no one living there. They could always be either tricking their atmosphere, engineering it. We actually wrote a paper about that, how you can use lasers to hide your biosignatures as an advanced civilization. Or you could just be living underground or underwater or something where there's no biosignatures. So you can never really disprove there's life on another planet or on another star. It has infinite avoidance. And then finally, the third one is that we have incomplete physical understanding of the universe. And so that's a challenge. Those three things are really, really difficult in terms of experimental design for a scientist to work around. Something that can explain anything, can avoid anything, so it's almost unfalsifiable. And we have this very limited knowledge of the infinite possibilities of physical law, and we're probably only scratching the surface. Each time, and we've seen it so often in history, we may just be detecting some new phenomena.
Despite the lack of definitive evidence, scientists have found many indications that suggest the possibility of extraterrestrial life. For example, the discovery of water on Mars and other planets in our solar system has led to speculation that these planets may be capable of supporting life. Additionally, the discovery of exoplanets in the habitable zone of their star has given scientists hope that life may exist beyond our solar system. However, these indications are still far from conclusive, and much more research and data collection will be necessary to determine whether life exists beyond our planet. If we were to find life beyond our planet, would it likely be different from anything we've ever encountered before? Scientists believe that extraterrestrial life could have different biochemistry, relying on different elements or molecules to sustain life, or it could have a different anatomy, adapting to the different conditions of its environment. Understanding the differences between extraterrestrial life and life as we know it will be essential in discovering and communicating with any forms of life that we may find.
Even if there are other civilizations out there, they're never going to be at a point which is in technological lockstep with us, similar level of development. Even intellectually, the idea that they could have a conversation with us, even through a translator, I mean, we can't communicate with humpback whales, we can't communicate with dolphins in a meaningful way. We can sort of bark orders at them, but we can't have abstract conversations with them about things. And so the idea that we will ever have that fulfilling conversation, I'm deeply skeptical of. And I think a lot of us are drawn to that. It is maybe a replacement for God to some degree, that father figure civilization that might step in, teach us the error of our ways and bestow wisdom upon our civilization. But they could equally be a giant fungus that doesn't even understand the idea of socialization, because it's the only entity on its planet. It just swells over the entire surface, and it's incredibly intelligent, because maybe each node communicates with each other to create essentially a giant neural net. Mm-hmm. But it has no sense of what communication even is. And so alien life is out there is surely going to be extremely diverse. I'm pretty skeptical that we're having a dialogue with another civilization.